Was that rat shit match, nerdy old twat? Hi! Jesus! Hi, welcome to the broadcast. It's Man vs. Game! Thank you, everybody, for joining me here tonight. Where I don't have a schedule anymore. I never had one. I'd like one. Someday. Someday when I get all my shit together, when I get only poop in a group, maybe I'll have a schedule, but for now, it's just a one-man show. And I'm trying to, you know, just keep all the, tend all the fires that are, you know, popping up everywhere. yeah, fuck schedules. I don't like schedules myself, but I understand, you know, how they work. They're good. They can be good. I've been wanting to play some more Batman. Hey! Green D 267, welcome to Mankind! Whoa, there we go. I almost wanted to call you Granddaddy. Who is another great band. In fact, I'd say I like Granddaddy even better than Green Day. But that's neither here nor there. How's everyone doing? I feel low. I mean, not like emotionally. I mean, like my volume, like my mic is low. That's better. Okay, so did man ever talk about his Dark Souls 3 event he went to? Well, I did, but it's just not in my blood to spoil shit. Well, I mean, I didn't record my gameplay. Is the bottom line. The bottom line is I didn't have a. Husband on point. Yes. What was I even talking about? Not the Dark Souls 3 thing, but the why did I joke about us getting married? I forget. Anyway, it's probably because you're just always standing around in your Man vs. Game mantis. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about Dark Souls 3 right now. I just talked about it a little bit. You know, Lobos Jr., Peeverson, Vati, Vidya. Those guys, you know, they put out some excellent videos. Because they all recorded their gameplay. I didn't. I don't have a mobile, you know, way a capture card. Like a way of capturing my gameplay. So maybe next time. For me, it's not that big of a deal, though. I'm all about, you know, usually I try not to spoil these games for myself. This time I just couldn't pass up the offers, you know, when Bandai Namco is emailing you saying, like, hey, do you want us to fly you down to take a sneak peek at Dark Souls 3? I'm just like, I guess, sure. It's hard to fight that. So yeah, I did spoil the first 3 hours or so of Dark Souls 3. I'm so hyped. It's so fucking good. It's funny to me that, like, there are still people on the Dark Souls 3 subreddit who are actually, like, worried about the game, and, like, for me, like, what I have seen and what I have experienced, like, it's just excellent. Like, everything is just fucking better than ever. Definitely better than ever. Definitely better than Dark Souls 2, but Dark Souls 2 is great! I'm actually really excited to get back to the Soul Level 1 all-boss clear that I'm currently balls deep in. I don't know if we could go balls deep. I really just started. I have just the tip. I have just the tip in, because we're three bosses deep. We've got 29 to go. 29. What was I thinking? The combat is definitely inspired, or you know, partly inspired by Bloodborne, just with, like, the speed, like the combat flow is much quicker. It's great. It's wonderful. So how about that Ghostbusters trailer, huh? God. I thought they were going to do something exciting with it. I thought, like, it was going to be new and fresh and not completely creatively bankrupt. It's like they assumed that just swapping out the Ghostbusters for an all-female cast of Ghostbusters, like, that's all they needed to do. And then they could essentially just make the same video, the same movie again. That's what it looks like. I mean, trailers are, you know, it's only a little bit of the movie. Could still be good. But didn't look too promising. Did not look very promising at all. When I saw that they were, like, just blatantly doing the exact same, like, first encounter with the ghost in the library type scene, I was just like, what are they doing? What? We don't need this again. You don't need to do it again. We had that. I don't know. It really was really bad. It was, like, really, really bad. And, you know, of course, it's this controversial thing because it's, you know, it's the all-female cast. But it's like, that's not what bothers me at all. I was so excited. I mean, not like so excited, but I just thought, that's cool. I just want to say this. I'm all for diversifying everything. Diversify all the things. I will just say, you know, like, like in comic books, just a quick example. You know, at first, when like Marvel was really starting to diversify a lot of the superheroes, at first I didn't like it. You know, from my perspective that I always, you know, sit from, which is that of like the old curmudgeon, the old guard who don't like change, blah blah blah. I didn't really like it. I was like, oh man, come on now. You know, he's always been white. He's been white. And that guy's always been white. And, you know, and then, you know, I start to realize, like, oh yeah, that's not the world we live in anymore. So it would be, it is kind of weird to have a, you know, a whole universe of superheroes who are all basically white. Bunch of white, male superheroes. So I'm all about, you know, I honestly think Marvel's handled it very well too. Like, you know, like, I think right now we have a black Captain America. Thor is a woman. Miss Marvel, I believe, is Arabic? I don't know. Anyway, but they're just diversifying all the bonds. And it's good. I think it's really good. I think it's good for, like, moving forward. You know, this movie just looks bad. That's the whole thing. In fact, the way I feel about it is it looks like wasted potential, like wasted talent. I think the women in the movie are very funny, and they've had a lot of, you know, funny movies in the past. It's like, just looks like a sad kind of cash-in, really. Well, because they've already talked about how, like, They already have, like, Ghostbusters planned as, like, a whole, like, it, like it's another cinematic universe. It's like, you know, producers, they don't just, like, make films now. It's like, everything is world building now. It's like, it's no longer just, you know, an experience. It's no longer just a film, a game, a book, or whatever. It's like one fraction of a whole that is, like, the whole, like, story of, like, the world and everything. So, like, is that what they're doing with the Ghostbusters? I heard that's what they were doing with the Ghostbusters as well. Is that, like, they already have, like, two more Ghostbusters movies, like, planned out. Yeah. I don't know. What did you guys think of the trailer? Yes, you can't tell me how gorgeous I look. Because I need that right now. Honestly, thought it'd be better if Marvel made brand new characters instead of rehashing old ones. Yeah, but what happens when they do that is, well, you know, the it's so much harder for, like, new characters to catch on and, like, you know, become as, you know, it's hard for those new characters to stand shoulder to shoulder with, you know, the likes of all the, you know, the classic, you know, the greats, the superheroes that everybody knows. So, You know, I also like the idea that the titles, or you know, the superheroes, it's like a mantle that you wear. You know, it's like the role is passed down from generation to generation. You know, again, I wasn't at first. I wasn't really thrilled with the idea of Miles Morales. You know, kind of being the new Spider-Man. And I think it's great now. In fact, earlier I was just thinking about spoiler alert. I want to talk about Superior Spider-Man. So I'm gonna spoil the shit out of Superior Spider-Man. It honestly, Superior Spider-Man would have been such a great chance for Marvel to actually pass the torch from Peter Parker to Miles Morales. They've really kind of done that already anyway. But, like, they really, really should have just left Peter Parker dead. And, you know, Miles could have really taken up the mantle, you know, fully at that point. Yeah. Because, yeah, the ending of Superior Spider-Man was just shit. The undefined one. Like the Tao. Welcome to mankind. The undefined one. Yeah, like they've got Miles in the, you know, the standard, you know, Marvel Universe. Well, because that was part of Spider-Verse. How they kind of like destroyed a bunch of, like, whatever, other dimensions, other versions of Spider-Man. Yeah, Bejong, I thought it was stupid, too. There was really no setup for it or anything. It was just like, hi, I'm Peter Parker, I'm back. Like, oh, okay. No one dies. I know. But, you know, imagine how cool it would have been if they actually did that. So, I don't know. Did I miss this up? I'm sorry, I don't have my dashboard up. Because I'm a dumbass. Let me get it going over here. Twitch alerts. There we go. But, you know, I just want to say, I calls them like I sees them. And when I was watching that trailer, I was just like, ugh. The thing that I didn't like was that they just looked like they appeared to be rehashing so many gags and characters and plot points from the original. And it's like, what is the point? Do we need this? Does the world need a Ghostbusters movie? Like, I mean, really, I mean, let's just call it for what it is. I mean, Ghostbusters was really, I read somewhere, but it's so true, but it was like lightning in a bottle. It was just like such a fucking weird idea for a movie, and it somehow worked. It works, you know, on the strength of the actors, you know, the strength of the actors in the movie, particularly Bill Murray. I mean, the wit of Venkman really, really keeps that movie flowing and going, and you know, it just, I don't know. Yeah, I really wanted to see more, like, new original things happening with the new Ghostbusters. It's like, I don't need to see. Well, I'll just say it. Like, it bothered me. Okay, I guess, what is the deal with it? Is it a reboot or is it a sequel? Because I guess if it's a reboot, you know, I can understand some of the decisions, or, you know, like, the decisions will make more sense to me. But if it's not a reboot, then, like, why did there have to be three white girls and a black girl? You know, it's like, did it have to be such a carbon copy of the original movie? It's like, it's okay to do some original thing. It is a reboot. they start the trailer with 30 years ago, you know, three scientists saved New York. That's not rebooting anything. It's like, wait a minute, before we reboot this, remember the original? Well, forget about the original. I was going to say, I don't think it's a reboot. I don't think it's a reboot, because the trailer starts with like 30 years ago, three scientists saved New York. You're like, okay. And that's kind of, I mean, that's what I was excited about, was, you know, I like the idea that, you know, possibly one of the characters could have been greatly inspired by the original Ghostbusters. You know, I don't know. I guess I was bothered that it was just such a carbon copy of the original movie. I don't know. I'm just thinking about Force Awakens now, because that was, you know, Force Awakens, you know, I think the reboot aspects are what bothered a lot of people. Anonymous! And it actually just says anonymous. I was expecting, like, ass titties. Thank you for the $5. It says, hey, man, I just wanted to let you know how much you help. Wait. I can't read, goddammit. Hold on. Hey, man, I just wanted to let you know how much help you have been in my life. I got hit by a car while running and almost died. Jesus, like Stephen King style. When I was in the hospital, all I watched was you, which put a smile on my face. Let's put a smile on that face. It made me laugh like I never have. Thank you, Anonymous. Thank you so very much. Stories like that are like, they just, they definitely make me feel bad when I miss, you know, a cast. Just because I'm like not feeling good. Meanwhile, somebody out there is hit by a car. They're like, I hope Man vs. Game cast tonight. I'm like, I'm not casting! Because I'm a douche. Thank you, Anonymous. I hope you're doing better. But thank you. Also, I want to take a moment and thank JazzyNYC99 for sending the $50 last night that made me quit the cast. I'm weird. I can't take a compliment. Thank you, Jazzy. It really was. I was just feeling so shitty. And I felt like from that point on, I started to feel, you know, like the sort of, you guys have supported me since day one, and it's always been like mind blowing. Like, I've never gotten real comfortable with it. But yeah, when I get in a particularly bad mood, it's like, then, you know, everything after that seems like you know, like pity tips or pity help, which I hate. I really need to see a therapist. I really, really do. And the problem is, I don't want therapy. Here's my problem. I can't stand accepting help from anyone for anything. And it's obvious that I need it, though. So it's like, and I've managed to push away everyone who is able to sort of like, you know, get through to me how badly I need the, you know, the help. And so I'm like, okay, whatever, I would like relinquish. So now there's no one there. And so I'm just like, no! It's like, I've closed up even more than I have in the past. It's a lot of fun. Should we play Dark Souls 2? Soul Level 1? I think so. I think it's time we get the death going. Whoa! Look at that! I got it ready. Rip Raring, ready to go. I have the fire going. I don't know if we'll be able to see it. Oh, there it is. Yeah. The fire is going. Dark Souls 2 style. We're going to keep the embers.
Macho Madness. Ooh, who's this down by the fireplace? Ooh, yeah. I'm gonna ruin his day, yeah. Let me tell you something, Mean Gene. You think you can just lay by the fire without contributing a single thing? Come here, ooh, yeah. Look like you put on some weight, yeah.
That's what he does. This is how he earns his keep around here. Just farting by the fire.
Whoa! Chaos Zero!
Oh, baby! You're a little cutie! Come here!
Smell my finger. Ow.
I can't beat the burden boss.
Okay. That is quite enough of that. That is quite enough of that. It's a cute overload. Oh, it's putting the camera in the wrong fucking area. Whoa! Look out for my toothpick arms. Ah! Oh, right. Let's get back to the game. Who was that? Chaos Zero. Welcome to mankind. Thank you very much for that support.
Let's go!
Oh, but I got the fire going. I plan on going. I'm gonna go all day Friday. It's becoming something of a tradition, just because it's me constantly trying to make up for lost time during the week. Whoa! There we go. That's better. Okay, let's get in there. Just gonna just fade that out. Yeah. Oh yeah. He loves me. The game may not have been exited properly. Yeah, because it froze up. Also, I didn't log out, so it's going to be like 20 hours or some shit on my account or on my on this run already. No, oh, Victor!
No!
Here we go. Now, just a little bit of bad news. I am going to close it up again. I am going to close up the man cave. So apologies to non-subs, but I do like offering the sub-only chat as a feature for subscribers, people who actively support me and keep me going. Like, it's very important to me. I'm gonna close it up, and because I just can't stand people telling me how to play the games I play. So we're gonna close it up. I hope you all, you know, I need to, does somebody know what the fuck they're doing? I need to find somebody who knows what they're doing on Discord so that we can get an open chat available there for anybody who wants to congregate in a chat room and, you know, tell me how to play the game, because I'm not going to be looking at that chat. I don't know if that even matters at all, but so I'm going to close up the man cave. Apologies to all the cool people out there. Suck it to all the haters. Keep hating.
Blocking out the haters.
Have I seen Deadpool? No, I really have no interest in Deadpool. So, subscribers, on! We're in there. So it is subscriber only mode.
blocking out the haters.
Do I trim Martin's nails a lot? No, I trim Martin's nails like zero. He just naturally trims them on my furniture. So that's wonderful. Anyway, soul level one, man! Let's fucking start the madness all over again. We got a lot of man fists here. What's happening? Oh, there he is. There's the guy. Need some better pants. Looking high. Alright, so not many souls.
What are you doing? You motherfucking insect wizard! Welcome to mankind! Booby dooby! Boobs!
Holmes, you're... This is why you're an honorary mod around here. Because you're cool. You're one of the good ones. You had a ticket to ride. Wix, welcome back. Thank you for the 9 months. Okay. All right. Let's... I was trying to get to the old Dragon Slayer. So... Let's just take care. I want... So annoying because I was worrying on... Oh man, they added a note on the Estus Flask Edition that it can't be filled. We won the war! Oh, it's still sad. It's still so sad. It's not like the saddest thing in the world. I mean, I don't have a whole lot to actually complain about, so yeah, I get to complain about Prima adding a fucking... And isn't it tiny? Isn't it like, it's, whoa! Isn't it like about as big as this flask? Because it was supposed to be like 6.5 inches tall or something, which is like, I think only slightly taller than this. I don't know. It's definitely, it's disappointing for sure, especially when you consider how much people are paying for it. You know what? I got a bone to pick with this fucking, Let's go this way. Let's go from this bonfire. I want to get this old Dragon Slayer taken care of, so I don't have to ever deal with the Spear Hype Knight again. This game is just so fucking cool, though. I love these games. I'm so excited for Dark Souls 3, man. I feel good. It feels good. You're doing good. Oh! Whoa! What the fuck, Chuck? Sploosh! Dip my nuts in your soup? Wow. RyanDog30, thank you very much for the purchase of a fine Man vs. Game shirt. Why would they give you a flask that can't be filled? I don't know. I'm gonna turn this down just a titch. Yeah, we're off to a great start.
Ooh, yeah! Let me tell you something, man. In Ring Leak, man. I'm getting better than Macho Madness. Oh, yeah.
Oh, we got Anonymous. Another Anonymous. Like, actual Anonymous is the name.
Oosh.
Oh, my God. Just please. Oh, my fucking Lord. Why did I start from this? I shouldn't have done what I did. Hold on. Come here. There it is. Still not dead! Die, you creep! Oh my lord. Oh my goodness. Oh my damn. The collector's piece. Yeah, I don't understand it. I mean, I guess I do. I mean, but like, how difficult could it have been to just, like, you know, just make it cup-shaped? You know, just let... If, you know, even if it's not made specifically to be used to drink Sunny D out of, like, at least... Just, you can make it so that, you know, some idiot can at least try, which, I know people will do that, like Peeve. I mean, obviously, Peeve is going to do that.
Hey.
Oh, yeah. Okay, what is this? I got to get this guy out of here. Yeah, it's like, all you got to do is just, you know, make it out of non-toxic material, and then just make a mold... that is vaguely cup-shaped. And there you go. It's like, you could even... You don't even have to say that you can specifically use it. Anonymous, thanks for the $5, says, thank you for the entertainment, man. Keep up the good work. I really fell in love with your stream.
Love me do.
Says, don't forget, you got the Twitch community behind your back. Yeah.
Sure I do.
Whenever needed. Also, don't forget to smile. Don't forget to smile. Okay, I'll smile.
Keep a stiff upper lip and all that. Jesus. Never mind. No, I won't. If I can't say it, I'm not gonna do it.
Also, John Major 69, thanks for the $10. Says coffee fund. We in there? Oh my God.
Really gotta get used to using this mace a little bit more than I am currently. See, that's not good.
Oliver of Steel. Welcome to mankind! Ooh, yeah!
Alright. Smile less, please. Yeah, this is the way I feel. It's like, if you don't feel like smiling, don't smile. If you feel like smiling, then, you know, go for it. I don't know. Alrighty. Oh my. Let's just go this way. Yeah, people who smile all the time, they kind of creep me out a little bit. Oh yeah, so we cleared the way to well, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's what I want to do. So I have the other room. I have another channel on the Man vs. Game Discord server called Freedom, which the idea is that it's going to be an open chat for anybody who wants to. Whatever, gossip about me or whatever the fuck. Hopefully we can get some mods in there. Keep things from getting, you know, like, oh, I don't know, the Man vs. Game subreddit. I'm not sure how to set it up like that yet. Oh, God. No, I want to go for the big one. The really big one! Oh, my God! My fucking balls! Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. Who is setting the Discord thing up? I don't even know. I have no idea. Nobody. That's the thing. Like, I don't have a crack team of people willing to work for free for me. I don't know how I failed in that. What is... Oh, God damn it! Oh. What is this? Hold on. This is such crap! There you go. There you go. Just take him out. One by one. I fucking hate that move! I hate that face that you're making! That face... That one right there! That neighbor face! I hate it! I challenge you to endure a face-making! Did anybody else watch that No Small Parts that focuses on Crispin Glover? Oh my God, it's so good. You should really check it out, if you haven't. No Small Parts covers Crispin Glover. But that's where that was from. Pretty good setting up Discord stuff. Hang out in Discord all the time. Help if needed. I guess I just, you know... Fuck Crispin Glover! Whoa! What are you talking about? Fuck Crispin Glover! I'm actually just curious. Crispin Glover, I think, is a great actor. I think he's a great actor. I love... he's very Kaufman-esque. He reminds me of Andy Kaufman. Which, for me, is all good. I think he's got, yes, there we go. I just want to say, Finster, it's refreshing, it is refreshing to read opinions that do not coincide with my own. It really is, I don't mind it. I don't mind it. Everybody always, the picture they paint is that I use sub-only mode because I don't like dissenting, opinions. That's not the case at all. That is not the case at all. Sub-only mode is... It's like 90% of the reason why I love using it is because of the backseat gaming. That's the shit I can't stand. Oh, you're thinking of someone else. Okay. who were you thinking of? Now I'm wondering who it was. You're just like, fuck him! Whoa!
Master of Worms! Welcome to mankind!
There we go. What was that? Oh!
Kaoden won! Yeah! Fuck! Oh my lord! Come on now. Get out!
This sucks. Oh man, I keep forgetting how fucking slow it is to, oh god! Yeah, it's okay. Alright, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine, we're fine. We're doing just fine. Usually says, oh, hold on. The voice actor, Crispin Freeman. Oh. I don't think I know Crispin Freeman.
You tit.
There we go.
You! God damn it!
Oh my fucking lord! There you go!
Crunch and munch it.
Oh my lord, you fucking did. Unbelievable. Furiously RS, thank you for the 25 fucking dollars. Wow. Since I just got done playing Bloodborne at a friend's place, my first time experiencing a Dark Souls game, and it was amazing! I will be buying a PlayStation 4 or PC for myself to play the games at my own pace. Thank you for turning me on to these beautiful games. Aren't they, though, just, like, the best? Like, they're just so fucking good. They really are. I love reading, I love hearing that. I think I decided the other day that Bloodborne is, in fact, my favorite video game of all time now. I think so. I think it's a certainty. Bloodborne is just so good. It's crazy, but it's weird. It's like, the lore... It's so good. The Bloodborne and lore... The lore of Bloodborne is so good that... It outshines, you know, the Dark Souls shit. Like, I'm really excited about Dark Souls 3. Really excited about Dark Souls 3! I am doubtful that they're going to be able to, you know, create such a mind-blowing experience with the lore and the story. For me, it's really... Dark Souls has always more been about, like, the setting... The sort of like aesthetics of Dark Souls, the mechanics, the lore is all, you know, was always great. Please don't get me wrong, I love the lore of Dark Souls, but like Bloodborne is just exquisite. Protocol Death, thank you for the 8 months. I gotta move on. What I'm trying to do is just. Give the excuse. I'm trying to make the excuse that I'm just, you know, farming armor pieces right now.
Oh my god, I missed! I fucking missed!
Oh, let's dance. Let's do a little dance. Nope. Twat. No. Yeah, he's going for it.
What? Somebody!
There it is.
Club you over the head with it.
Damn. Because, yeah, right now it just looks like my guy needs, like, some pants. Just looks like I've got, like, dirty nylons on. With some, like, knee pads for masonry work or something. I don't know. Let's just not examine that any longer. Let's just cover that up with the old cape there. Not worth it.
Tiger Rider!
What is going on, dude?
Yo!
I am...
Had it! Motherfucking night! This motherfucking... Game! Bebop! Samurai! Welcome to mankind!
Gonna hit you with the...
Bop gun.
My very, very white bop gun. Why I gotta be racial, man? But new music from my favorite artist and a new great book to read. Nice. Who? Who's the artist?
I know, it's only going to get harder. Like, this is... You know, this area always sucks for me, though. I have What is the deal with that?
He is so going to fall over the edge. Better. Alright. Okay. Didn't drop a damn thing. That figures. You guys should totally follow Tiger Rider. which is obvious. I mean, if you're not following Tiger Rider already, I mean, I don't know what to do for you.
Help me help you! Yeah, I know. It's the despawning, you know. I disagree with it, with, you know, with it being in the game.
Whoa. But as long as enemies do despawn, I will cheese it.
What's this? Oh, demonic Skeletron! Thank you for the 9 months. Oh my god.
I've got to get something better than these dirty nylons going on.
Whoa!
Here we go.
Now you die. Minimalistic, what's going on, dude? No! Oh! I need to get that stone ring back from the hippo in the beginning in Things Betwixt.
I'm gonna go get that. Later.
Shit! Punk.
There you go. There you go. There we go. Here we go. Around the mulberry bush.
There is still Halloween.
As I die. And I like the way they handle it in this one. I like the way Halloween works in this is each time you die, your overall HP bar is shortened only a bit. And so it's a much more gradual Halloween. It's a gradual process that happens. Which I think is better. I mean, it's... Makes more sense to me than like the way you would go hollow just immediately after dying one time in the original Dark Souls. And I certainly like the way it's being handled in Dark Souls 3 from what I can tell so far. Do I know the Muffin Man? I don't. I also don't know Brown Man. when I saw that there was a Brown Man who casted Twitch, I was like, maybe I should have called myself White Man. Just to, you know, differentiate. I don't know. Oh, God.
Oh!
Scumbaggerino!
What are you doing?
Okay, let's go for the biggie. Big easy. There we are.
There it is.
Okay. Okay.
Ha! Fuck off! Oh my god, he's not gonna fuck off! He's not fucking off! I repeat, he is not fucking off!
That's too high. It's too high. So many brown jokes. It's because I'm a white supremacist.
That's one thing I chose not to draw attention to, even though it is fucking hilarious.
There's somebody who, for a while, they may even still be doing it, but there was somebody who was whispering all of my viewers, all of my subs, you know, requesting or suggesting that you not support me because I'm a known misogynist and white supremacist.
Oh my god. Like, it was just... like, just wow, man. Just wow. All that shit does is just... It reminds me that I have indeed made it. I made it, guys! I got my haters. They're everywhere. During that hater aid. Wowie! Oh god.
If only I could make it to the old Dragon Slayer. Here we go.
Yes! Rock this motherfather.
Oh, you responded to that guy and he just said he was really bored? Oh, that's wonderful. I'm glad that, you know, he's able to, find excitement in sullying my good name, you know, wherever he possibly can on the internet. That's great. That's part of this this objectification that happens. This this dehumanizing of human beings as they gain some kind of popularity in the world. It's okay. It's okay because they chose this path. It's okay to just totally. Whoa! Fucking. That's great. I love hearing that. Like he's just doing that out of boredom. It's like he doesn't even actually care about me. There we go. I'm actually disappointed. Like I was hoping that it would be, you know, a hater. It's like I want a real hater, not just some guy who's bored. Oh God! You devil! Oh. There we go. I'm still dying. I'm still dying now. There we go.
I have the power.
I lost the power.
You roll! God!
This sucks. Why is he all the way down here? You're not supposed to be here. No drop. No drop. Oh, come on. Come on now. Why did I start from this bonfire? I guess in my head I was like, well, we could just take out a few of the hide knights who are wandering around. Have I told you my thoughts on the Hyde Knights wandering around in the Hyde Tower of Flame now? I think I have. Loving my shirt. I love my shirt too. It's like nylon or rayon or something. It's very cool. On to the touch. Oh God.
Ha ha! No.
Why must this be this way?
Hey!
Let's just go this way. Yes. I know what is happening. Yes, yes. Ah!
Jesus! H. Christ!
On a fucking rubber crutch. Yeah, now I'm literally a white knight. I am literally a white knight. But I'm also fighting white knights. Like a fucking hypocrite!
Ah!
God, I just can't get enough of that fucking move.
Neither can he, apparently!
Can you just not, though? Whoa. I know. I did pick the white armor. And I also prefer the white gummy bears. Apparently Booby Dooby is not a fan of the white pineapple flavored gummy bears. I don't know what the fuck his problem is. Like, dude, what the fuck? Whoa.
God!
Why am I so bad? You know what it is? It's just that, I'm not usually, I don't usually use the S2s, or not the S2. I'm a big fan of the S2s. I usually don't use the mace. That's the problem.
Ashram alive! Thank you for the donation of the beast! Just a minute!
I gotta get in there!
Come on, one more! No! Oh, he still didn't fucking die. He still didn't fucking die. What's wrong with you?
Hold on, Ashram alive. Thanks for the 666. Says hi, man. The donation of the beast.
Cheers, and thank you for your cast again. When will you come to France? Have two Carpenter Brute places for Paris concert in May, and it will be great to have you there, Manfist.
Why you gotta remind me of that? Yeah, isn't Carpenter Brute playing a show with Perturbator? And like basically every other badass Outrun synthwave artist, retrowave, whatever the fuck you want to call it. I like Outrun because it's also the name of a video game. Alrighty, soon they shall be despawning.
Whoa, there's not, I don't have the Discord server. Yeah! Drop it. There you go.
Ooh. They're going to be too heavy. I don't know why I'm getting all excited about getting the armor, but...
Balls.
Well... We can still roll. We're still rolling it.
Is there a place where I can find you, your logo for this Discord server?
Well, now, you should have an invite in your user settings in the connections.
Since you are a sub now. Thank you again, Booby, for your support.
Oh, you just need a pretty M logo and then a couple of things from you. An M logo. I don't have an M logo. I just have, like, the Man vs. Game logo. God, I'm so ready for new everything. I am so ready for new everything. Here we go. Just get in there. Just...
Survive! Yeah! Get the fuck out of here! Oh my gosh.
Okay, there you go. Yep.
No, 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 no! Oh! God. Damn it!
Always.
See you later, John Matrix 69. Take it easy! Another drop!
Ah, my Night Sword. Alright. Can't really use that. That's okay.
There is already a server. Yeah, there's already a server.
And the sub only
chat is there. It's been there.
We've been done, had that. It's just, I would like to have an open channel for people who want to, you know, talk about how awful I am at the game. Or what have you.
Yo!
Look at this fucking... I can't believe I didn't die. I'm actually stunninated. Let's see here. Give you powers. Let's see. Do I have Discord open? It is open. See, this is what I mean. Like, I don't even really know how to, like, give people powers. Oh, here we go. There you are. I see you. No, that's not you. Okay. When I... The hell is this shit? Yeah, I don't even really know what the hell I'm doing right now. Should not surprise anyone. Oh, you're not... Okay, crashed. Okay. Yeah, I need to get a link on the info section anyway. Well, because that's my plan, I guess, is the link is going to go to the open channel. Or so I'm assuming. I don't even know how the fuck any of this shit works.
Trauma Hawk TV! Welcome to mankind! Enjoy the sub only emotes!
24/7 access to the man cave. And access to that Discord server. Ooh. We'll use a life gem.
Use a life gem.
Oh my god, that'd be wonderful. So much information that just blasts me in the face. Constantly around here. Oh my god, this run up to the old Dragon Slayer in Scholar of the First Sin is just
fucking ridiculous.
Excuse me for saying, but this is just fucking ridiculous. Because they really did make it so that, like, you're not gonna be just running through, you know? What in the hell is going on there? There we go. Get out of here. cough. Another one, I guess. The addition of the new boss seemed odd. It makes... I think lore-wise, it makes... tons of sense. And it is, I did reply! excuse me, I'm just having a private conversation here. Oh god, there we go. Yeah, the extra boss they added in with Scholar of the First Sin, it doesn't make sense to me. But oh my, who's this? BT! Welcome to mankind. I appreciate your support. BT. And excuse me, that is a welcome back to mankind. As I get my ass kicked by this motherfather! Oh my god. Oh, sweet bastard! No! I will eat your soul! This game is not random, no. There's really almost nothing random about this game. Drops are kind of randomized a little bit there. But ultimately, there is not a lot of randomization at all. Just give me the pants! Just give me the... Oh my god. Yep, we got it. Ah, that's fine. Sidereal X, in your user settings on Discord, if you've synced up your Discord account and your Twitch account, you should see an invitation to the Man vs. Game server in the connections area in the user settings on Discord. Oh, what? This guy should be, like, nearly ready to go. Like, I don't understand what's happening here! Okay. What the fuck, Chuck? The hair is getting long, and Luda, what is going on? There's a part of me that, like, I feel like I... Ooh, nice. I feel I definitely need to get a haircut, but, oh god, I think I'm dead. Oh. Yeah, you need to just go the fuck home. Run home, Charlie! Run straight home! So tired of this fucking shit. Oh, my. Jesus. You've got to be kidding me. Fine, I guess we're gonna fight this dude now. Yeah, you better back on up. To wake him 3.5 hours. Ew. Grody. What are you doing? Dim shoot a snare off. By the way, Luda, what is going on? Yeah! Has he not turned yet? Oh. Thank you. Any drops? Nope. Okay. The invite isn't always instant on Discord after syncing. Oh, okay. Okay. Hopefully, yeah, let me know if you have any troubles. It's such a new bit of software for me. I still, you know, obviously do not fully grasp it. Oh boy. Oh, my iframes though. It's so bad. I fucking hate that shit. Sometimes it'll take an hour or so.
Oh! Meta time! Welcome to mankind!
That was exciting.
Thank you, Metadime, for the support. Come on into the man cave.
Where we should be talking about something interesting. Instead, we're talking about Discord shit. Come here, I'm just gonna run on up. Say, fuck these fools. Really should have gone. I forgot that I really had totally cleared the other route. I should have just gone from that other bonfire. But we all know that I secretly love playing these games for as long as I possibly can, so...
Hey, Silky!
See, man, I messaged you on Discord with what basically I need from you, and I can handle the rest from there. Okay, hold on. I'll just make sure I'm not going to get... Ooh, they coming. They really don't have, like, a threshold where they return home, do they? What is he doing? Fucking Big Daddy? Okay. You heard Meta Knight? Oh. Big Smash Bro fan.
Smash Bros!
I still have not played Smash Bros. Since they added... Bayonetta. You just finished watching Dark Knight Returns?
I have seen it.
I loved it, actually. Thought it was great. I'm just gonna run up there. I'm actually going to do this again. I can't believe I'm doing this. Still waiting on your man shirt.
Oh my god, Falky, I'm so sorry. I don't know what the deal is there. Oh my god, I don't know what the deal is here either. I'm dead. We dying now. Oh!
Okay, at least they went for the... Oh god, he's gonna blow that fire again right in my face! He's gonna blow up my face! Oh! Son of a bitch! I'm so close. What the fuck, Chuck?
Ho 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 ho! Wowie!
Okay. This is interesting, man. That's fucking interesting. Oh, damn it. You should be doing way more damage than that, you fuck.
Crunch and munch it! Oh, why though? Yeah! Get fucked on, bitch! Ow!
Okay, that's enough fucking. That's enough fucking. Crack it. There you are. What the fuck? Don't do it. Just gotta look out. If he flies up, I'm fucked.
Oh! That's it? We got there, baby!
Petrified Dragonbone and the Watch Dragon Parma. That wasn't even a boss. I mean, it's a boss much later in the game. Which, you know what? Speaking of which... That's one reason why I think it's pretty cheesy that they have that fucking Drake right there. It's like, that right there, that Drake is a boss way later on in the game. Usually with the flow of these games, they, what the fuck, they, you know, usually you'll fight the boss first, then they'll use it later as like a random mob somewhere. It's like, Scholar of the First Sin, they're just like, whatever, just throw whatever the most difficult thing we can possibly put, you know, in that area, just put it there. Okay, Discord.